Hey guys, Ollie from greenteaguru.co.uk, and I'm speaking to the wine guys at the moment. You like collecting wine, you like appreciating the taste of wine, you like laying down wine and seeing how the flavour progresses over time, generally turning into something better. Did you know that tea has many similarities to wine? Let's find out more. Now, I'm going to introduce you to an amazing tea. This tea comes from Yunnan in China. It's called Pu'er tea. Now, opposed to many other types of tea, this particular type of tea can actually be aged. It ferments slowly over time, changing the taste and characteristics of the tea. So, similar to wine, in that wine aged in a barrel or wine aging in a bottle will change over time, the same thing will happen in teas of this nature. Now, the first thing you'll notice is this particular tea and most other raw pu'ers will come in a disc form like this. It's called a bing or a pu'er tea cake. When you open this cake up, you'll notice that this tea is compressed to form this cake. And very simply, you break it off and you brew up the tea in something called a Gai Wan or a small teapot. And what you're doing is you're doing a long series of short infusions. So 5 seconds, 7 seconds, 10 seconds. So you get many infusions.
Now,
from this tea.
Just as wine ages in a barrel or in a bottle over time, the tea will also age in a disc or a bing.
Basically, this cake is fermenting slowly. It's still alive. There is bacteria on this cake which is slowly fermenting and changing the characteristics. So in a bottle of wine, the high acidity and high tannins that you may expect in a bottle that is being produced to lay down, you'll notice those tannins and the acidity slowly drop over time. The same thing is with this particular tea. The majority of them start off very bitter and very unapproachable to many people. But over time, the bitterness will disappear and slowly turn into sweetness and other complex tasting notes that are very enjoyable. Perhaps maybe peach, apricot, fruity notes, plum, stone fruits, maybe mushroom or earthy notes. The other interesting thing about tea, pu'er tea, is that the flavour notes are also regionally specific, just as you have your complex appellations in claret and other areas. There are areas in Yunnan, they're all broken up into tea mountains or tea areas, and you will notice different characteristics associated with these different areas. The terroir plays a massive part in determining the flavour. So with this very fine bottle of Gran Reserva Rioja 2009, this probably started life being very lively, a bit of a racy wine. Over time, things are dying down, giving way to much more interesting characteristics. You'll find exactly the same thing with tea as well. The amazing thing about raw pu'er tea is that it can be aged indefinitely if given the right conditions. And we're not going to go into all the major specifics, but the right conditions being a right humidity, so between sort of 60 and 70% relative humidity, this cake can age indefinitely and just get better and better. The notes will be more complex, the cake will be more desirable. Just as with a bottle of wine, over time it gets more and more desired because it's been hanging around for a while at the right conditions, but also because the particular bottles of this vintage are slowly getting drunk over time. The same thing is with these cakes. This cake is from a particular year,
This one is a CNNP factory release. I believe this is from 2003. Just as these cakes have been drunk over time, there's not many of these left of this particular cake, of this particular vintage. The price is driven up. The same with tea. The bad thing about wine is that it gets you drunk. Well, it's not a bad thing, but you can't drink too much of it. Tea doesn't get you drunk, but it does give you a certain accelerated feeling, potentially with good tea. Now, of course, there's caffeine in tea. This particular type of tea contains a lot of L-theanine, which is another kind of drug that is sometimes exploited by the pharmaceutical industry. It gives you a sense of relaxation, of contentment. So you get a, sometimes people say you get tea drunk. It's because there's a mixture, I believe anyway, a mixture of caffeine and L-theanine contradicting each other, giving you a sense of alertness, but at the same time, relaxation. An interesting difference between wine and tea is that with wine, not all bottles are expected to get better with age, especially, for example, with something like Beaujolais. This is a sort of wine that's supposed to be drunk fairly quickly. It doesn't really have the characteristics that are looked for aging or laying down a wine. Whereas with tea, on the most part, they can all be expected to improve over time. Some more than others, and when you're talking about fine tea, tea that is being processed very well from a very sought after area or region or appellation, whatever you want to call it, will generally improve in a much better way. So yeah, I really hope that I've opened your eyes to a brand new world of tea. And if you have any questions, any comments, please feel free to get hold of me either at my website, greenteaguru.co.uk, or just leave a message down below and we'll get straight back to you. All the best, guys, and happy.